Hopefully you'll do that for the next one. So we don't wanna do anything without October 1st.
I wouldn't like.
Okay.
Terminate these if we need. At the most, you're just gonna pay for it. It's not.
Sorry. Yeah, we can go for a second.
Anybody wanna entertain a motion to put this up for bid?
Guys, there's two parts that aren't filled out. When would you like these gaps by?
Next meeting. Yeah.
If we put it out right away, we can get them all back by the next meeting, so, yeah, when's our next meeting would be the one?
February 19th.
They can't take too long.
Do they need to come back that fast if the lease starts on the 1st of May? Do you wanna give a little more time?
Well, see, a lot of people wanna get them out for bid. I like to get them out sooner than later and get it agreed upon, because the guy that's gonna get them, he might be into the year of buying seed yet then. So that's why something they gotta really wondering what's going on, cause they get the early seeds.
Yeah, there's a lot of people buying the seed. We got a whole plan, we got to plant it.
Right.
So do you want them due the Thursday before or the Friday before?
The Friday before, we have plenty enough time.
What's that date?
February 16th. By 4:00 PM soon?
Yeah.
Hold on, is that gonna work?
No, we gotta do it Thursday.
They gotta go to highway, it's gotta be Thursday.
Yeah.
At 4:00 PM. February 15th, right?
Yeah.
Proposal will be reviewed at regular monthly highway committee meeting on February 19th.
That goes in the paper too. Is that where you put it? Scott?
Yeah, I just need to go to the paper and we could also put it on Facebook too.
You're pretty fine with the.
I like a motion.
Second. Any more discussion on it? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Update on keeping safety simple training.
We kinda talked about it at the last meeting there about our training, Dustin Thompson. I did, this is a quote I brought back to you about his training and everything that keep us in compliance for the next year. If we wish to continue on with this training, this is what he proposed for us. This will be for 8 sessions, which is more than what we need, but that will cover everything that we need for anywhere from OSHA to MSHA training and keep us within standards for the state.
You have to see your budget somewhere.
We'll be pulling this out of each area of our budget and they're from flag topping to any of that, so it'll be coming from all, through all our whole entire budget.
Okay.
Because it kind of pretty much touches on everything.
I think it's well worth it to prevent one accident, you know?
Oh yeah, it's well worth it.
Anybody wanna make a motion on it?
No, we took this out of ARPA last time, paid for the entire. But we don't need it anywhere else in the county, right? What the thought is right now?
Will Forest you be able to help use this to them, like for their chainsaw training to, I'm sure he does that, right?
We go different fiscal, whatever, we will do it, but yeah, they could join us in any of our classes, forestry, any of that, they join them.
So Wisconsin County Mutual supplies like chainsaw training, but it, the highway department is so specialized and they need so much training that I think we should go with Dustin for them. Forestry, land con, maintenance can probably get away mainly with alternative options.
say aye.
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 Talk to property, request to use ARPA funds for purchase of one pickup truck, one tandem axle plow truck with underbody and one on the wheel.
Why you put that back on, we tried, I've attempted it before, we went for two trucks, I'd like to go back and see if we could either go for a pickup or a single axle, or a, not single, but a tandem axle state truck with the underbody and rear mount wing, because the trucks are getting very, very hard to come right now. And they're getting pushed out further and further all the time. So I was wondering if I could attempt this one more time with property, with ARPA fund, to see if we can get something to go for another truck to get it on board.
So you want either one or the other?
Well, if they allow one or the other, I'd like to see another, you know, plow truck come, but you know, if we're allowed to get a, you know, if another state truck, a tandem truck with a pickup, that'd be fine too. We are finding some places with these pickups that we're actually running pretty good deals on some of them, you know, anywhere from, you know, what is it, 63 to 80 some thousand dollars for, you know, random trucks. These are all, you know, like 450s or 350s.
Do you have a price on them? If you put the tandem axle truck, how much less is that than the tri, really? Not that much. Price difference, probably.
Well, you're
probably about the same, because you're throwing an underbody underneath it, so.
For what we took in that price off our tandem trucks and our bid was 160, whatever it was for them trucks, them were tandems. But the only difference is that you don't have a $10,000 pusher or anything. So, and that gets added in when you start wrestling. You know. Because right now, it would still be nice to keep a smaller, because right now, all our single axle dump trucks with the underbodies that we do use are getting, they're getting to be quite the old too. You know, I kind of like to update one of them at least to a tandem. You know, that to be just, and basically be running state all the time.
Are you looking to replace a truck or something out of a fleet pickup truck?
Looking for what?
Are you going to replace a pickup truck out of the fleet?
Well, we could definitely, yes. We got plenty of pickups, we got a whole garage and
23, 24,
yeah, we got quite a few of them that are, I think our oldest pickup right now that we still have is one in 98.
Yeah.
I think 23 is a 98.
So what happened with the two or three that we lost last year? There's a couple.
All that money got put back into the general fund, wherever it went.
No, but we lost a couple, three due to safety.
Trains.
Trains,
yeah.
Yes, right.
We got rid of them, never replaced them.
Okay.
We never replaced them.
We did one, right? With the used to quarter ton you got?
Yeah, we got a shop truck.
Is that what that was for, the shop truck, the three quarter ton?
Yep, the moving parts and stuff, yeah.
But how much do we have left then in your, what's your estimate of having left in the equipment fund that was in your budget for 24 after the two plow trucks are purchased? Or is there other uses you're looking at for that?
Well, the two plow truck purchases is coming out of the $780,000 levy money that we levied for them two trucks. That's where that money is coming for them two plow trucks.
Right, but there should be some left.
There should be a little bit left, but we ain't gonna say how much until it's finalized and sitting in our doorstep. Because it could, price could vary just a little bit, you know, because of time delay. We're trying to push it as fast as we can to get them here to hold them to the price.
Or is there something else we need out of that too? That's why I'm asking. Because I thought you'd have at least enough out of that for two plow trucks and at least one pickup truck. Was my thought process when we started with that, but if you don't, or if there's something else that I'm not aware of that you're
going through all of our equipment, going from worst to the better shape of what we need, and we're working on a list right now to hopefully have it all complied for the February meeting, where you guys can see where we're standing on our equipment.
Well, I have no doubt you need that pickup truck.
Yeah.
I was just waiting how long it was gonna be before you asked for one. I figured you'd probably ask for two, because I thought we lost three last year, but.
Jim, that 750 they budgeted for them two dump trucks, we can't use that money on a pickup, they'll come for it, that's dedicated to two dump trucks.
The 750? No, it's just putting the budget $750,000 for equipment.
No, it specified two dump trucks.
Not in the county budget. Not that I remember. Unless that got snuck through somewhere else along the way, but when the budget was done, I remember it just being 750. With no specific strings attached to it. So I mean, you could've got one truck and one loader, I mean.
Because I think we did most of that pretty quick.
Yeah, it's just equipment under your budget that I recall getting approved by the board. So if the trucks go as planned, you should have enough there for at least one pickup, hopefully, if there's not something else that comes up.
Right.
But we don't wanna blow it all out the door the first 2 months of the fiscal year either.
This is just the whole, the property of the approval.
Right, seeing that, I bet those will be approved, but it's a try.
Well, we still gotta have a plan going forward for how we're gonna, you know, what we're gonna need, what, you know. Summer's gonna come, and even if you, why wait till May 1st to try to get a pickup truck too, if we need a pickup truck?
A lot of the two, the plow trucks, cars, you get your hands on.
True.
That's the build time, that is so far out, so if you get another one in place, that would possibly drop, what, three on the ground? Which updates that equipment a little quicker, but if it were me, I'd go for the plow truck. All you can do is try, but pickup, you know, there's half a dozen, so to speak. It'll be easier to get your hands on, so to speak.
Is there a motion to approve this property?
All right, any more discussion on it? You're not all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Next is Highway Commissioner's Report.
All right, everything's been going pretty good at the highway there. As you guys know, we do have a shop foreman in place now. Today's his first day in that position. So we do have a shop foreman now that's going to be keeping care of the equipment, letting us know what's going on, and keeping a better handle on.
Who's the shop foreman, Scott?
Our new shop foreman is Justin Livingston.
Justin what?
Livingston. Yeah.
So what's the update on the blacktop plant?
We did receive the funding for that for storage. I do believe Rich Summerfield got that other check on that. That's where everything was going to, was to Summerfield. So as far as I know, he's been staying in contact with them on that.
Yep, so we're paid up through February with them, and that money's been deposited.
Okay. Gravel pits, I'm hoping to, we're probably going to be doing some crushing this spring, and we're going to make a binder mix for our blacktop, and make a primary run for our gravel, for our roads, for what we build roads, because right now we have no primary, we're completely out. So we're looking at, right now I'm trying to figure out how much we're going to need of each one of them, so that's something I'm looking into, because I think I put in for 80,000 tons of crushing for this year. So we're kind of some pits that the township has gravel in our pits, so. We do got all them named now. Bill's updated a little bit on that. I had an email from her the other day, wanting to know if they could push the project out till 2027, 2028. And my email back to her was no, there was the federal funding was there for 2026 to be finished. We like to stay on track and keep it going because it's due to the forestry and everything that's due on that county hemp project. That we'd like to keep it forth in motion to keep everything going. And she agreed to it so far because, like I told her, I don't think she'll last till 2025. It's really not that good of shape, and we don't want to stick extra money into it when it's supposed to be completely done, you know. So that's kind of where we're sitting at with that Bill's project right now.
Yeah, the gravel, you might want to get started on that too, so that get on to kind of get your mind up there.
You're putting out on bids?
Yeah.
Yeah, we gotta get a bunch of stuff compiled there. I think within the next month or so, we gotta start bidding up for oil and everything for asphalt and all that. So I'm hoping to have all that ready here. And we'll get it up for ladder out of oil bids.
Yeah.
Sure, the truck plan there, you do.
Yeah. Kind of a little update too. I've been working on some LRIP programs right now. We did get three more compiled in. I think if all of these go through, we'll have pretty close to $1 million in two LRIP programs right now that we're going to be eligible for. So, to kind of give you a heads up on that, that we're working on.
Okay.
The bridge inspections is another one that I kind of want to touch on. The state did passing a bill to help all look at all these little bridges 20 feet and under. They want to know every township, every county, every bridge that we have 20 foot and plus, and see what condition that they're going to be in. So they are pushing on that a little bit now. They're realizing that we are going to be needing help because there's a lot more of them out there than what they really thought there is. So I know they're going to start, they want to start compiling all the information on it. To get it back into the state to see if there can be if we get some funding to help replace some of these. So we are working on that right now too.
Will the funding be for the bridge and the inspection? Because I think the township pays for the inspection, don't they?
The towns pay for their own inspections. The county would pay for
it. I mean, I wonder if this whole bill would cover that too.
Well, the first inspection I believe is going to be covered by this new bill that they're passing. Because nobody ever inspected a 20 foot and under bridge. It was never doing, so now that the state is actually paying people to do them now and to locate them and do them. So the first time around, I don't think that there'd be that much charge out to these townships for inspecting. There could be some, I can't say 100% here because it's kind of a gray area.
Sure.
Of knowing what's paid and not paid yet.
I hope they include that in there because otherwise there'll be another.
Yeah.
Like
20 foot and under press, that's every frog pond that's by the road.
Right.
Anything else?
Yeah, I got it. Scott, you know, we adjusted the hours for the artisan yelling and all that stuff. Did that work out pretty good?
Yeah.
You know, for the invoices and all that?
Yeah, it seemed to be good.
Those work out there.
Yeah, and the people coming in for sales and all that representatives, they got everything done. As I say, you don't have to backtrack now. Everything is staying pretty good. We've been, if there's anything to do with any that township that needs something, university, whatever, they contact or on call phone, and we, you know, we pretty much got covered right now.
That was a good adjustment.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
You got here. What's your projects on here that you're doing here for 24? I know you said it once before, but. Got everything in line for that?
Yeah, we're going to be looking at the county people. It's going to start at 27. I am trying to straighten out the outreach program on that right now. I'm trying to work really hard on getting that straightened out. If not, we can always transfer that outreach program to another road. But in the meantime, right now, concentrating on County Peak Ball. My goal is to pave that from 27 all the way to Parker Road, I believe is gonna be over there by Brian Shrubs. I wanna get that whole stretch, we're gonna start a stretch, I'd like to do it continuously once they're jumping around on different projects. I'd like to get on that one and run that one all the way through and get it done.
What's that, roughly 3.5?
That'd be roughly all together, for 3.5 for sure, but I think all together you're gonna be pretty close to about 7 miles.
Oh, okay.
So it'll be one continuous project. Instead of all surround projects, moving here, over there, where I'm like, yeah, we can go. And then we're still gonna have some rough paving to do and some wedge filling jobs to do yet too for next year.
But you've got that figured in right now.
Yeah, we got approved for $3 million for 2 years for for blacktopping, so it gives us $1.5 million per year to blacktop right now. And if we can get these outreach programs straightened out with that 1.5, that'd give us a pretty good hedge. The only problem with these outreaches, that some of them we may not be able to do the blacktopping on. We may end up losing the blacktop, but we might end up building, lay the blacktop, but we may have to haul it out of them on our plant. That's the only kind of a downfall about our outreach program. But there is help out there, but it will raise our GTAs, our road averages, which also will help the money come back in too, but it just, we need to get the tonnage to our plant.
I was at a township meeting the other night, and is there another program for assistance on cave roads the state coming through?
There's a couple different ones out there. You can get the, well, you got the elder, you got the Tri-D and Tri-Estas, you know, some of the different homes. The other one is the STPs, the federal funded ones, them are the big bulky ones where you just be all the engineering. And then our, basically when you go for them as a complete overhaul of the road reconstruction, kind of like County M up there.
Right.
There is that one, it's called STP Royal, I believe it's gonna be. There is one of them out there. I don't think it's gonna take a lot of engineering in them, but some of them I heard that you can use them for overlaying and whatnot. So there's another program out there, but it's gonna be a 5 year spec.
I'll stop out and get more information.
I'll dig up some more of that on. That is all I have for the regular report.
Anything on the CG report? Financial report.
First page, the packet there is just winter maintenance cost to date. Just a little bit remaining that I need to get in there. Next one is just equipment to date, cost and revenues on it. Then estimated financials, the December billing estimate is at $93,000. Our equipment fund balance at the end of November is $519,000. Blacktop plant fund balance at the end of November is -$304,000. Next reports are just the budget transfers for November and then balance is left in there. The AR report, we did get that outstanding damage claim paid. DA's office was a big help on that. And then the other damage claim, the 4300 there, that is with Geldwin, and they are in the process of paying us for that as well.
heard you're supposed to be like an 80-20, and they have an 80, and run over 100%, they charge you for it, and they were trying to hold it back, but not pay the 100%, because we weren't supposed to be responsible for the 100%, but now it's all coming back that we have no choice, we have to pay them. So we're trying to collect on some of these old bridges that are very old, that's been out there for a long time.
Which probably wasn't in the budget either.
Well, maybe 8 years ago.
Okay. So then they never got built, but they tried to use the fund somewhere else.
Yeah.
Did you ever get the final cost on that highway D down there? You know, after you had to go in there and revamp it and all that stuff, did it?
Emily, she should go pull that up.
No, just for, because I know you had quite a bit of work to remodel it.
Questions on the financial report? Move on to the payment of invoices. So I had one question on it. We were using our own sand, not buying the wash sand.
We don't have wash sand, we have screen sand. The difference between the wash sand and screen sand is that it takes the clay out of it. If we tried using our screen sand before, and if we don't get the clay out of our sand, it plugs up the sanders, and then it becomes a safety issue, a major safety issue, because it plugs up and you can't get the stuff to run inside the augers. So we've been using kind of like a wash sand from Haas to mix in with our clay sand and just thin it down and make it go through, and we've been having good luck with that.
Well, you have to, this is probably just half of the wash sand. You're probably going to end up ordering more Haas.
Here at some point in time when we're making material, I don't know if it'd be feasible to see what would cause Haas to come in and take our screen sand and wash it, or
I'd like to see us go straight to wash sand completely. Maybe have our own pile on. That would help our asphalt plant out immensely. That's one of our main problems is dust. The dust control in the bag house, why we can't run as fast as we should be able to. It's going to take up so much dust. So we're using that screen sand, and it's plugging our bag house. It's making a less than adequate asphalt, because you're getting clay pocket chunks coming through the plant. So if we could wash it, it'd be awesome. That goes for our right now we have like a one mix design. It's got quite a bit of clay to it. It's another problem that we're having. So we need to start washing a little bit.
How many tons of wash sand do you think you need for a year? Now on here you got 4,657 tons to mix up to just salt sand.
Right. So we used to have our own wash. We used to have come in or Olenek at that time and wash it all for us, but our last commissioner decided to go with the screening instead, trying to save some money. But I think there was, if I did the math correctly, there's not much savings. So
because your blending is,
you need to get your 5/16 chips, we could get out of washing, you get your 3/8 minus out of it, if we just washed it, but have to buy it continually from us. So I'd like to see if we could have a wash plant come in. And
I would recommend to get a hold of somebody, see what they would charge to come wash.
Yep.
Some tonnage to put on next month's agenda, get a quote for us so we can look at it.
Yeah, but if you're overspending too long.
Yeah, if you're overspending on buying wash sand every year compared to how much it's going to cost us to have some made at the pit, need a report for that going towards next month. Is there a motion to approve the bills?
So move.
Second. Any more discussion on them? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Curious. Is there any committee announcements?
It's cold out.
What?
It's cold out.
Next meeting date, February 19th. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
We'll make that motion.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
I'm not in it for
I feel like the short one.
This is the shortest one I've got.